comes Santa Claus, here comes Santa Claus, right down Santa Claus Lane. Vixen and Blixen and all his reindeers pulling on the reins. Bells are ringing, children singing, all is merry and bright. So hang your stockings and say your prayers, cause Santa Claus comes tonight. Here comes Santa Claus, here comes Santa Claus, right down Santa Claus Lane. He's got a bag that's filled with toys for boys and girls again. Hear those sleigh bells jingle jangle, oh what a beautiful sight. So jump in bed and cover your head, cause Santa Claus comes tonight.
All right! Oh, Julie the Elf. Oh, and Mr. Santa Claus, give me a hug. I'm your wife. Get it?
Ho, ho, ho.
Ho, ho, ho! I can't even dance with him. Oh, my goodness. Merry Christmas. Bye, Santa. How much do you think he got paid to do that? Oh, and look how cute Julie is. Show him your shoes, Julie. Yeah. This is Elf Julie. Tiptoe. Is she adorable? All right. So thank you, Julie. You're all done. Yay! Do you like her red glasses? You guys all look red out there. This is to see values. I'll probably need this a little later today. But aren't they stylish? They're so stylish. You ready? Ah, it's Eleanor! Oh, my gosh. So guess why we did all of this? It's for our quilt. And it's called Chimneys and Cornerstones. Did you get the chimney? I mean, to move that chimney right into here, what luck, huh? So, look, I even have my Christmas quilt. Isn't it cute? It's adorable. It's adorable. And I have to tell you, Teresa and I worked together on this, and we got so excited that we finished it so quickly, we forgot to put on borders. We said, oh, we like it. Let's send it to the long arm quilter, and it was off. It was really fun. So this is the block. It's 14 inches square. Good. And there's how many colors in it?
Four.
You got it. Four. So number one is red. Number two is green. Yellow is number three. And blue is number four. Got it?
Got it.
Okay, this is a lap robe. 3 by 4 or how many blocks? 12, 3 by 4. And then we wanted to do something different. We wanted to be very modern with our lattice and our cornerstone right here in the center. So we surrounded it with the lattice fabric. Nice?
Nice.
Oh, and then the green border. It's so much fun. So Mrs. Santa Claus did her part. Can I go put on normal street clothes now?
Yeah.
Merry Christmas!
Ho, ho, ho!
And now Patty and Teresa are going to take over. Give me a minute. I think, Teresa, do you remember when you made me this dress?
I don't remember. No, yes. That was a long time ago.
It was a long time ago.
It still fits.
It still fits. Are you kidding me? I could put a reindeer in here with me.
I know, that was a long time ago.
I don't think Santa would approve.
But I think your ladies have a good stories to share while Eleanor gets back, because she wants to see and talk about all her quilts. How about that?
Oh, you're gonna tell a Christmas story? Oh, then Patty has to tell about when we were growing up.
Oh yeah, there you go. Patty's turn. Okay?
Oh, nothing like an impromptu.
Any of you would like to have any?
I'll say something. So every father's dream is to trick their child into believing in Santa Claus. Well, I think she does believe in Santa Claus. My daughter Kylie, the first year that she ever saw Santa Claus was my mother, Eleanor. She came down the stairs and she's looking at her And Santa passed out all the presents. And when Eleanor came back, Kylie looked at her in like a little way and said, ho, ho, ho. She knew it was him. And again, this year, we were watching TV, and there was a man playing Santa. And my brother dressed up like Santa at his Christmas party last year. And he goes, that's like your brother, Grant. So anyway, I thought he was believable, but she couldn't be fooled. All right, that was my stories. Da-da-da!
We got our first sewing machine. It was Christmas Day, and it was given to both of us with a big family. Sometimes you didn't all get your own present. You got to share. We got to share clothes. Well, there was a beautiful little sewing machine. And Eleanor, of course, being the older sister, not much older, she opened the present, and it was a sewing machine. It was a little hand crank one. And she started sewing and sewing and sewing. And younger sister Patty never got to use the sewing machine. And that's why to this day, you probably notice Eleanor always does the machine. And I like to do a little handwork. And it all goes back to that first sewing machine. But it's on record. I don't know if have you shown it, Orion? I'm sure we've seen it. We've seen it many times. Yeah, I don't know if you've all seen it, but you can see Al just cranking away, and Sister Patty just sitting there in days, just overwhelmed by the thought of a sewing machine. But
that's
funny.
Patty, how old were you?
Yeah. How old were we? 1955.
Yeah.
I must have been 9. Al was 10.
And there was Eleanor Burke.
And you know what's the really funny part? I have a mic. Okay. I don't need it. That's for you. Okay. So what's the really funny part is that I never knew that I hogged the sewing machine until she announced it on national television for the first time. Nice and sweet. All right, you ready to see the quilts?
Yes.
I heard Mrs. Claus was here.
Yes.
Did she look good?
Yes.
Oh, good. Good. Well, we have such a really neat stack of chimneys and cornerstones. Are you ready? So this one, yeah, I think you still need the mic, Patty. Oops, I forgot my spot. No tape on the floor. Is this good?
Good.
Okay, this one is just a little four-block baby quilt. I had so much fun doing it. I think it was an afternoon of sewing, and it goes really fast. And this one, we were so excited, we forgot to put borders on it, too. So you didn't make any noise at all. Do you like it or not?
Yeah.
It's adorable, isn't it? I just think it's so cute, but anyhow, it's really fun. And basically, these are the two dark colors that are opposite each other, and then the two light colors are across from each other. Oh, where's my red glasses? We could see that. Oh, my red glasses. Pardon me? You want to give the glasses to the camera? Sure, why not? So it's basically two. Can you see it? Does it look good?
Oh, my gosh. Definitely.
Oh, look, you can see it. Oh, Ryan, you're so clever. Oh, Santa Claus, you're so clever. So it's basically like two pieces that read solid across from each other, and then two pieces that have texture to them across from each other. So it's just really fun when you pick your fabrics. And this one I thought would be an adorable baby quilt. A little gift, or just, you could even use it on a round table on point. Would work great. Four blocks, one afternoon, you're done. Merry Christmas.
Can I ask you a question about the red check
No, I didn't do anything. I didn't take a long time at all. Actually, this is how I say it, you know, like we, the nurse, you know, like I always say I, but it's really we. Teresa cut it.
She said how fun it was. You repeat that.
Yeah, it was really fun. It was really fun. Okay, this is Teresa's. Are you ready?
Oh, wow.
Oh, look, now you're making noise. Huh? And she didn't put borders on either. I'm telling you, we were having such a fun time, we forgot the borders. But anyhow, she took a stack of fat quarters, And instead of using like one turquoise, she used four different turquoise. And the same thing with the purples. Each one, she used a different fat quarter for each round. Starts in the center with a nine patch, and then each round goes out like that. And so when she was doing her cornerstones, she also did a different light color for her cornerstones, and her lattice in between is all a mix of her fat quarters too. Nice? I know where you can get a really nice stack of fat quarters. And it's really, okay, so last fall, I liked this pattern so much that I took my fall fabrics and I just sat down and just whipped it up. And you know, it's really funny. Talk about forgetting everything. We forgot the lattice and the cornerstones. And this was another fun day I was having, just so much fun. But it was beautiful. It was fall and Julian. And I just wanted to have this to hang on my wall. So that's why it looks different. Were you looking?
It has borders.
It has borders. I saw you looking from this one to that one, and it looks entirely different. All right. You guys all might need sunglasses right now. All right. Ta-da! Look at that one. Is that beautiful? Teresa did this one. This is twin size. Okay, 3 by 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 3 by 5. How many blocks? 15. It's a nice long quilt. And she remembered she put a border on and a binding. But isn't it fun? So you can see the way the blocks are turned. If you look at the pink, basically, if you just lay out one block, then you keep on placing the next block beside it, and you can see how they rotate. There's two positions, pink at the top, pink at the bottom, pink at the top, and then this row starts the opposite so that you get that. That's a chimney. Does it look like a chimney? Yeah, you got to squint at it, but you see a chimney, and then that's why these are called the cornerstones in between. But each one of the fabrics I have been pulled from this multicolored piece that was also used for the border. Very, very pretty. And I think that it just has overall quilting on it. Let's see the back. Yeah, you have to see it on the back. Overall, edge to edge, just loop-de-loop. Isn't that pretty? Big loops, really big loops. Really, really fun. Okay. Oh, so this is the leftovers. Ah, the leftovers. And unknown to me, Teresa gave it to Patty as a Christmas present. And I kept on saying, no, that's ours, that's ours. Patty said, no, Teresa gave it to me. But you'll see the way the yardage is written that you can comfortably make the 15 blocks for the twin, but have extra fabric left over for 5 more blocks. So what do you do with the leftover 5 blocks? Make a little table runner. Make a table runner. And actually, Teresa, Patty has a really little table. I have a really long table.
I wasn't here when they were discussing that. I thought it was hilarious.
Well, Patty, it's payback for that sewing machine thing.
Well, you want to hear the rest of the story was Teresa had leftover fabric, and I was trying to figure out how I could have her leftover fabric. And I said, what are you going to do with your leftover fabric? And she said, oh, I'm going to make another quilt. And then she realized I wanted her leftover. So she said, oh, here, this is your Christmas present. So.
Oh, show the backing. The quilting is really cute on the back.
Oh, yeah.
Oh. Isn't that cute? Very, very cute. It looks like the ribbon candy. Go really close, because it really just looks like that ribbon candy.
Oh, yeah, it does.
Doesn't it?
It does.
Very cute.
That's better.
Very, very cute.
Did you do it, Teresa?
No.
Judy Jackson. Yeah.
You all might want to send a Christmas card to Amy. Amy is down and out right now, but she's home recovering, and I think she'd love to have a card from you. Or at least a call, not to ask her to quilt your quilt, just to say Merry Christmas. But that's for Vicky.
Do we have her address here?
Oh, we have her address. We won't put it on national television, Amy.
Okay.
Okay, so this is Patty's, and this one is beautiful.
Thank you.
No, this is not a table cover.
It's a bed runner.
This is a bed runner.
People have been telling me we have enough quilts. We want to make bed runners. So that's didn't start out to be a bed runner. I made 9 blocks for just a little quilt, and I kind of made a mistake. But if you look at the block, instead of putting the two darks opposite one another, I put them side by side, and it was an accident, and I realized that it makes a diagonal stripe, and then I did something else a little different.
Here,
yeah,
Patty,
y'all see?
You need these glasses.
Oh.
It's called value.
Oh, I see it.
Now you do.
No, I didn't realize it. And then I said, well, I don't know if I like it as my quilt really looks stripy. So I laid it out as a bed runner. And something I did, if you notice, instead of the lattice separating the blocks, I used matching fabrics, matching. Uh-huh. So it kind of completes the square.
That's good.
And I didn't forget my border. And I found out if you use a really wide border, your quilt gets big really quickly. So that's what happened.
It's really cute. And I myself always have cold feet.
Me too.
And I love to have something just an extra thickness across the foot of the bed. Usually it's just my bathrobe, but this adds a lot of style, don't you think?
Yeah, and on a solid solid bedspread, solid color, this really adds, just something special.
So let's show the back. Look how cute it is. Isn't it cute?
Oh, yeah. I like the quilting.
Lots of swirling, huh? Yeah. Really, really cute. Very, very nice. All right, so let me think. I think this one's for later.
Yes, for later.
Don't look.
I saw you peeking.
Yes, I saw it. Okay, don't look. So, do you want to sew?
Yes.
Okay, you have your pattern. So, it looks really bright and festive, huh? So, you start, let's see. You've got your, how about let's just look at page 2. It's so cute because Merritt, our photographer, did really good close-ups on that first little quilt that you saw. It's kind of a lazy daisy print. Really fun, so you can see it. But this tells you about the block, about the center is made up of a 9-patch. Remember, center is the 9-patch, and then you have the 4 different colors going off from the 9-patch. And in this photograph, all of the chimneys are the same fabric, okay? There's 4 different fabrics, and they're all the same. But you can do scrappy
throughout. It's a really great scrappy quilt. So, but in this one, all of the fabrics are all the same. That's how the yardage is written. The cornerstones are the white, the light, and then if you look in the picture on the left, your lattice is the same color as the cornerstones, but I'm sorry, the lattice. You have the lattice, but the cornerstones are the same color as one of the chimneys, one of the darks. So see how it all goes together? So you get that little four patch. Whoops. Whoop. We're good, huh? So really important, take your quarter inch seam test. Oh, no. That means line up your strips. So three strips together, a 2x6, measure them. And when you measure those, they should measure 5 inches wide. Are you going to check and mark that and make sure you do it? Otherwise, you might have to be doing some trimming up on your strips. You want to have a quarter inch. It's not a scant. It's a good quarter of an inch. Okay, yardage. Next page. Oh, my goodness. Look at all of that. But it still goes along with the red as one, green as two, yellow three, blue is four. And it tells you basically we're using 2-inch strips. You ready? Turn the page. Beep. This was so funny. You know, my artist, Merritt, does all of the work. Merritt's been with me, I think, for about 30 years. And I emailed him text last night, and yesterday we started on a new pattern. And we were all running around this morning, getting our outfits on, getting all ready. And he said, do I have to have this ready to hand out in class? I said, no, Merritt, remember you did this a couple of weeks ago. You're working on January now. Poor Merritt, he gets so excited. But anyhow, these are the pieces for the center. And since this is just a wall hanging that I'm doing, four blocks, I have just 10 inches of each one of them. Or actually, basically, I took long 40-inch strips, whatever they are, and cut them into four. So that's pretty close, right? How long is a strip usually? About 40, 42. So you just take and you cut up your background strips, your lattice. And for strip number one, the first section, this is the red, right? And then this is the green, and green is number two. And we have to keep on moving. And now all I need is one more quarter. And number three is made up of fabric numbers.
Three and four.
Three. Thank you, Santa.
Ho, ho, ho.
Ho, ho, ho. Do you think that Kylie, remember when Kylie saw me as Santa Claus? She knew I was Santa Claus and she was only about 2 years old. She recognized me. I guess it was my glasses.
No, she was one.
She was one. This is how she couldn't talk. But the next time she saw me without my outfit on, she said, ho, ho, ho. We knew then we had a smart girl, huh? Okay, so this is strip set one with one. This is strip set two. And this is three and four. All right, three and four. Okay, so use your quarter inch foot, definitely. 15 stitches to the inch, so you're just going to flip. And now, did you turn on your iron, Teresa?
Yes, she did.
Oh, good. Okay, so I'm going to sew all of these together. I'm just going to flip them right sides together. And Teresa is going to press the seams toward the... No. Look. Toward the cornerstone. Whoa, I always forget. What do you think? Do you think Merritt makes the pictures too little? No, is that good? Okay, towards the cornerstone.
And so while I sew this together, Eric, could you show our little video of Christmas from the past? Hello. I didn't warn him.
Getting ready for the holidays is always so much work. But it's this moment that you see the magic of Christmas.
Audio.
The patchwork is hung throughout the house. The tree is decorated with angels and Santas, and those stockings are hung by the chimney with care. I appreciate the help I'm getting from my guests. Some arrived early, and some are arriving right now. Ooh, good. Hi, Grant.
Merry Christmas, Mom.
Aw, thanks, hon. For
Jesus
me?
For you.
Thanks. Well, are you hungry?
Always.
Well, let's get ready. You can help me.
All right.
Grant still says that. He's always hungry. Yeah, watch Teresa. Andy's. You narrate, O'Ryan. I can't see. Look, check out the hair. Nancy Loftus. Yeah, the German Christmas tree. That was Grant's first wooden project. Oh, yeah, we were all confused drinking out of other people's glasses. If you look and find a pickle in the tree, I'll tell you the pickle story in just a minute. Yes, we bought the turkey at the grocery store and just brought it in. Did you bring the sheet cutter? So is it over? No. Almost.
This has been so much fun. Well, I'm glad you came to help celebrate. Merry Christmas to you and your family. And may we all have peace on earth and goodwill toward men.
Is that fun? Thank you. Oh, that was fun. I asked them to pull that up in the control room because I want to show that to my grandchildren. I think they'll be very entertained when they see their daddies and just, you know, how much fun we have. And I bet your girls would really enjoy seeing that, Teresa, huh? Yeah, really fun. Okay, so here's my three sets. Wasn't that fast? Wasn't that smart? You guys didn't have to wait while I sewed it. Three sets, and the seams are all pressed toward the cornerstones. This is the set number one, set two, cornerstones, and set three. So what I'm going to do is just take set one, put it like this, set two and three and four, and I'm going to put it right sides together. This is the middle section of the nine patch. Ooh, and the seams should lock together. And when you put them like this and you feel and there's no ridge, then you'll know they're lined up. They're lined up perfectly. And I'm just going to put this one on the top, right? I got to get this done fast. So I'm just going to put it on the top. And before I do it, I'm going to measure it and make sure how wide is it supposed to be.
Five. You can go really close, O'Ryan.
Is that good?
Yes.
Very, very good. Okay, so I'm using the shape cut. I love the shape cut. I like this one because you can do half or 1 inch. Okay, one more turn. One more turn. I got it. Finally. I think we have the only mismanufactured shape cut in the building. No. I did that just to entertain you. Did it entertain you? So I need to have 10 good inches. Let me see. So if I need four times two, I can actually get 5 2.5 2-inch strips. Okay, so I'm just taking it at zero. Didn't sound really good and sharp. So just go at 2 and then 4 and 6 and 8. And look, even with a 10, I got an extra for a pillow. So take off the ends. Whoop. And get rid of this. Get rid of the beginnings. So now I'm going to just stack this all up. It's okay. Okay, I'm just going to separate off this one. And I have the middle of my 9 patch ready. Let's just check and see. Ooh, that looks good, huh? Yeah, and then when we're done, we're going to add that one. Perfect. That's your 9 patch. So I'm just going to pick these pieces, and I'm going to tell you about the German tradition of the pickle. There's like a little glass pickle that you can buy, a little ceramic ornament. You can get them about that big now. You can get them little, you can get them big. Well, it's been a tradition at my house for some time that you hide the pickle in the Christmas tree. This is a German tradition, and whoever finds the pickle wins a prize. So if you saw the little girls, Amber's and Melissa, Teresa's little girls, did you see them looking in the Christmas tree? They were looking for the pickle. And so it's just really fun. But I remember one time, the kids, you know, somebody said to Grant, can you find the pickle? And he said, no, I can't find the pickle. And everybody laughed, a little dirty laugh. But anyhow, I just want you to know that my daughter-in-law, Himna, that's Grant's wife, and Orion are both very competitive finding the pickle. And there's money in it. Yeah. Now I give a $20 bill. But anyhow, the last time I was upstairs getting dressed at the bear spa, and I think Orion and Teresa ran in. I heard all this laughing downstairs and all this scuffling. Orion found the pickle before anybody even got there. But Himna loves it. Man, she'll kill to find the pickle. She does. It's pretty amazing how good she gets. Okay, so I'm actually making 4, but I probably don't need to, huh? I'll have to catch up with this, so I'll just show you what it looks like. One more, finish it. I'm going to be setting a lot aside. Okay, so got all of them done. Let's take a look and see how good it is. Ooh, pretty good, huh? Pretty good. So then once you have the first 2 sets sewn together, then all you have to do is just add the 3rd set. Right sides together, seams lock. Okay, and get ready, Teresa. How are we supposed to set the seam? Look at the pattern real quick. How does it go? Away from the center. Okay, that one's not. Okay, I'm just going to have you do this one, Teresa. One done. This is for later. Pick it up. Swing it around. Get rid of it. There. Is that cute? Very, very cute. Very, very cute. Okay, now let's turn the page. Beep. Oh, we're going to measure right now. How wide is this supposed to be? Approximately. You'll be really good if you do it really 5 inches. You know, it's that soft thing, approximate, I hate to say. It must be Turn the page. Beep. Okay, so we're going to have our fabric for number 3. And this is what I did. I have actually the first round, the second round, and the third round. And these I just did all from fat quarters. It's pretty amazing. So this is round 1. And you always put it right sides together. See how you always put right the yellow next to the yellow, right sides together. You should be able to get 4 on this strip. Let's see if I can just zip it right down. So, Orion, you have to be thinking of another good Christmas story. I remember the year so well that I got my Schwinn bike. Whoa, that was really fun. And my dad would always take me up to the hardware store, and I got to buy all the presents. Did you know that, Patty? Did you know that Father took me up to the hardware store and I got to pick out all the presents?
Oh, I know that.
And then we would go back, my dad and I. What's that?
Do you remember, I never forgot, 1 year I got a Stitch reset and I never liked it. And Al and I were talking recently, and we were talking about her presents, and I said, 1 year I got this Stitch reset. It was like a George Washington Stitchery or something. And I said, I just never liked that present. And Al let me know. She picked it out for me.
I forgot that. I don't remember that. Okay, so you cut the strip exactly the size as the 9 patch. This is 3. And now you need to have the opposite side. You work on the opposite side. And this is 4. So you just go flip right sides together to it and stitch. Well, we were very fortunate because we had this woman that we called Aunt Georgie. She wasn't our aunt, but she was my mom's best friend. And every year, I would have to say, she sent the best handcraft gifts ever. And if I had somebody to thank for my interest in all of the crafts that I do, it was Aunt Georgie. So our gifts would always arrive maybe about the 20th of December. I couldn't stand it. December 21st, I was behind the couch opening my presents. Yep. And this is the biggest problem. Okay, so now you just cut it even. And you know that you would be assembly line sewing all of these down one after the other. And now, once again, you're going to set the seam with the fabric on the top and press it. But anyhow, I didn't have any fingernails. Do you know how hard it is to open Scotch tape with no fingernails? That's very hard. It's very, very hard. But anyhow, Aunt Georgie sent us the best gifts. There was always something, some craft that she did. Okay, so we already did 8 and 9. Is that good? 8 and 9. That is fast, especially when you're doing only one block. So turn the page. Okay, and now you're getting into your rounds. Red and green, round 1, and let's see, this is round 1, color 1, color 2, they always have strips of the cornerstones sewn to them, okay? So these are 2-inch strips, and this has to match the 9 patch. So take a guess, how wide is it?
5 inches,
you guys know. And that's why I said it's really important that you have a good seam allowance so you don't have to trim it back. All right? This is the first set. That's the second set. Looking good? Okay. So you just take this, flip it right sides together, line up the raw edges, and zip these right along. All right. Okay, Orion, did you think of a good story?
I have a good story, but I need a mic.
You need a mic. Okay, walk over to the mic. Put it on lockdown on the camera. Walk over.
I'll tell you my top Christmas present. When I woke up, there was a JVC color television, and it was probably 2 feet. It was big. And it had ColecoVision connected with a Smurf game in it. That was the best Christmas. We played ColecoVision all day long. It was one of those, instead of going outside and riding your bike and playing with, you know, all your toys with all your friends, we were just glued to it. So, anyway.
You know, one of your favorite toys that I loved was your R2-D2. You remember that little robot toy? You cried to have it, R2-D2? Oh, and you still have it. Well, this was really cool because it was like a robot that would bring you things. And the robot brought me a glass of wine. Wasn't that nice? We have a photograph of that, and I really love that. Okay, I have one side on. Radio Shack. That was really cool. So now whenever the kids are all getting Star Wars toys, we're all back again. Jonas loves his lightsaber from Darth Vader. It's crazy. They always say what goes around comes around. Star Wars is back with the addition of Angry Bird in there. It's so weird. Okay, Teresa, and how are you going to press the seams? Toward the dark, toward one red, two green. All right, cool. All right, so press that one. So does it look easy? It's very easy. And this is the kind of quilt that you could still get it done for Christmas. Okay, you have a second one.
Depends on what time of the year it is.
So, are you ready for Christmas? I haven't really had a chance to get too much done at all.
Eleanor, I have a really funny.
You have a funny story? Brenda, would you tell in the microphone? Okay, but first I'm going to tell you, as soon as Teresa is done, I'm going to pick up the shape cut, figure out where the numbers are, not upside down. One more turn, I got it! And I'm going to just layer these.
And remember, always grab the name of it with your right hand.
Okay, if I could just do that. Grab the name with the right hand. I have just a few too many on. Line up the edge across the bottom. And see, Orion, you don't get all of this. The problem is that my blade is really dull. Right. Yeah, we were so busy getting our outfits together that we didn't replace my blade. But now, I know, but we can't find it. Okay, look at this. I'm cutting even extra. So, are you getting ready? Okay, take that. Get rid of that. And now, let's take this 9 patch and put the same color. See, you can't find it. Aww, look at that. Aww, isn't that cute? That's very, very cute. Okay, so then you flip. See, right on page 11, you flip, and your seams lock together, and do 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 do. And after you get that one done, then you fold it back, and you take this one, flip it there, and go do 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 do. And it's all done with round one. Okay, now you get to tell Brenda, because I'm going to sew. Uh-huh. Well, okay, maybe you better stand up.
I don't have to stand.
Oh, can I see? You don't want to look at everybody?
Oh, I guess I do.
She can look at everybody just by sitting.
Okay.
I can sit. That's good.
Okay. Yeah, they can see you.
When I went to the university, I worked at the University of Florida at the veterinary school, and we had an engineer guy that was doing his internship there for his engineering degree. And for my Christmas gift, he gave me a home assembled, you have to assemble it yourself, Heathkit light dimmer. And I had to learn to solder and do all these wiring things to make this light dimmer. So years later, what do I marry? I marry an engineer. And I said to him, there's one rule about Christmas. I do not want an assembled appliance for my gift. If you come to the house with an appliance and I have to assemble it, it's out the door. So word to the wise, Heathkit's no longer in business. Now I know why.
I remember that. Yeah, I remember.
I don't know who would want that for a Christmas gift.
That's good. That's cool.
Yeah, another engineer, Ron, would like it.
Yes, really. You have one already?
Joan has a story.
Did you get up or sit?
Joan has a story. Cool.
My neighbors in Solana Beach had a little, since you have boys, you can appreciate this. My neighbors had a little boy about 4 or 5 years old named Jackson. That is not a lightweight name. And he got up at like 3 or 4 in the morning and wanted, we've all done this, got up too early and wanted to open your gifts. So to put him off and get him back to sleep, they said, okay, Jackson, you can take a gift down to your room and open it and then wait for the rest of the family to get up at 7. So that's exactly what he did. And when they got up at 7, every gift had made it down to his room and he opened every one of them. But he did it one at a time. And he would get partway down the stairs and open it and then realize he didn't like it. So there was just this tsunami of gifts. And nobody knew what gifts went to who because all the name tags. And his poor sister, he'd opened all of her gifts too. You can take one gift to your room one at a time.
That is too funny. That is too funny. All right, so we have a good center going, right? It's looking really good. So then when you turn the page, okay, I'm not going to do all the rounds for you, but you see now you do your next round of yellow and your next round of blue. Yes?
Yes.
And then you just keep on going, and this is going to be a miracle. And suddenly, your blocks are done. Ta-da!
She wants
motor. Oh, look, we match. Merry Christmas. See, Orion keeps on wondering what happens to all the inventory. I know now. He always says Teresa opens up new stuff all the time.
That's because you take it home.
Oh, it's because I take it home.
Oh.
No, I have really good. Okay, so you just keep on adding. This is round 1, round 2, round 3, and you have those nice cornerstones going right along the outside edge. I did use different ones. They're all scrappy, and the approximate finish size of this is 14 inches. Come, Teresa, you have to come and do it. Okay, 14 inches. So now it says on the next page to cut your lattice the same size as the size of your block. It could be only 13 inches, 13 and a half, something like that. But you have lattice, and it tells you for a wall hanging you need 12. And you need to have little, these are print squares. Remember the color of the chimney. And you need to have how many of those?
Nine.
Oh. Nine. You looked at the book.
I did not.
Okay, Teresa. So you get to place them on the board. Okay, now this is just like the log cabin. Put number 1 at the top. Number, put number 1 at the left. Put number 1 at the left.
No.
The red. Put
number 1,
Al. No, it isn't. Red
Which
is.
Which one do you want me on top?
Wait, I'm in charge. I'm looking at the book. We're going to do like the book. Number one is red. It always was red, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so that goes on the left, Teresa.
Right here?
Yeah, on the left.
Sorry.
Okay, so this is actually called like a log cabin. So you can turn the blocks in different directions. Like Patty said that she did like a fields and furrows. But the way we like to do it is just put down one block and then just base it off of the one block. Just start turning it. So see, she left room for her lattice in between. And she's just going to put each one of the blocks. Okay, so you just keep on turning it. And you just keep on building your whole size quilt. But you can actually turn the blocks all in the same direction, or you can just flip them out. Just try. You can make like an arrow, just like you do in log cabin, all these different ways. Okay, so now she's placing in her lattice in between. And these are the little print squares. They go right one in there. Isn't that cute? So this was when Patty said she used a lattice that would have been, see, like red you could do, or you can green in there or yellow, so it's not so contrasting. Okay, that's good. Now you slide over to the side. So I'm gonna put, I didn't? Oh no, make it up. Sure. Yeah, you're allowed to cut them. So does it look cute? Oh, that was a good one. Cool, here's another fake. You're good, we're good at faking. Oh, and one up there. Whoop. Okay, looking good? So then all you have to do is, I always assembly line sew. You're doing good. I really love it. I wanna finish this today. Do you think we could do it, Teresa?
No, after today.
After today. Darn, I wanna finish it today. I think it'd be really good. It would be really fun. So I always just flip this row over to the left, and I just assembly line, so connect, and then open, assembly line, top to bottom. Always do all the vertical rows, top to bottom, and then I go across. And it is pretty amazing how quickly you can put that all together. Looking good?
Yes.
Do you like it?
Yes.
Good. I like it too. I like it too. So now we have a little special extra treat. So we went through our whole pattern, right? Chimneys and Cornerstones. Very cute, all the photos. Okay, we're going to expand our mind. We're going wonky. Wonky, wonky. Okay, yep. So Teresa has a little niece, right?
Oh, yeah, niece.
A little niece. And her little niece liked the Chimneys and Cornerstones, but she wonked it up. Ooh. Okay,
she's
so.
My niece, because Orion came in the sewing room and said, hi, Aunt. No. Almost, but he kept looking at her and thinking that.
She needs her microphone.
She looks so much like Amber, right?
Okay, so this is her quilt.
I called my niece and told her I really need a little help, and so she came from Riverside, and I was going to put her in the classroom, but Eleanor was really nice and cleaned up her little area and said, you can sew here.
Wasn't that nice of me?
It was really
cute. I cleaned up my area.
And then if almost anyone that knows me, they could come and I say, hi, Amber. And then it was not Amber. It was my niece, Emily, from Emily Garcia.
And how old is Emily?
She's 18. She's freshman in college.
She did this. Okay, you ready to see this? Okay, this was Chimneys and Cornerstones. Wow. You like that? It's very vibrant, isn't it? And it's very contemporary, very 18-ish, huh? Very 18-ish. And it's really fun quilting. You can just see straight lines through here. I would say it's the modern quilting. Don't you think straight lines through there? And then here, look, it's like a whoop, 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 whoop. And then it goes up and down, really cute in the border. Okay, can you see the nine patch?
Yes.
Yeah? You got to squint.
Yeah, it's in there.
It's the nine patch. It's really the nine patch. And then you see each one of the rounds. See, they have, there's the chimney, there's the cornerstone on the ends, but she just wonked it up. She used her wonky ruler. This is really a nice print, huh? So definitely it started with this one. This was the inspiration piece, and she pulled the three others out of it. And then I think the dark for the cornerstones is really nice, huh? You want to see the back? You want to say something, Patty?
Oh, no. Somebody was asking me. She said, I want to get one of those wacky rulers.
Wacky.
I like that name, too.
Wacky or wonky? Yeah. Wacky.
Wonky.
Wonky.
But she thought it was wacky. She gave it her own name.
You better not say that. Okay, so everybody got busy with the wonky ruler, and this is what Teresa did. You like what she did? Okay, do you see the nine patch in there?
You know, when you look on the monitor, it looks
yeah.
Cool. Oh, it looks great.
It looks really cool. Look, you can see the quilting really nice, too.
Yeah.
It's really fun. Teresa did a red border, the same as her center for her nine patch. She framed it with the red. And a piece of rickrack in here. Isn't the rickrack fun? The rickrack is fun. I really like this piece. I'm using it for a fussy cut in one of my blocks that's coming up. You're not going to believe the backing. You want to see the backing?
Yes.
This is going to knock your socks off.
All right.
Isn't that very Christmas, huh?
Yeah.
It's Minky.
It is Minky.
It's Minky.
Wow. Do you know where you can get it?
Actually, we still have some of it on the sewing room floor. But Judy Jackson just brought it, and she is the long arm quilter, and I asked Judy if it was hard to quilt on Minky, and she said, no, not really. But with Minky, you need to do dense quilting. She said, if you don't do dense, the Minky just kind of like sags out of the back, sags out of the back. So she said, do dense quilting. And, oh, yeah, fine, Judy, do dense quilting. So she did it for us. But isn't it nice? So all different styles in there. Okay.
She said, how do you make it wonky?
We're leading up to it. It's the suspense. Are you getting excited?
Yes.
How come we're taking this one back?
Oh, here.
Okay.
I want to show them two things that I didn't know what we were doing. We didn't have those numbers.
Okay. Hi, I'm microphone. I have a mic on. Oh, my gosh.
Okay. These, I don't know if you can. Let me see.
We got to get it.
All right.
Behind.
I don't know if you can see both of the quilts. They're both done with the same ruler, but the blocks is a little different. It doesn't matter if you turn your ruler back or front. You get the same thing. And they're both done a little different. I was testing the ruler. And so this was done with the front. And this was done with the back. And I was trying to Orion explain it because he's the one that kept telling me that. And so we did it both ways, and it's the same thing, really. So if you have your ruler back, just continue to use your back all the way through, okay?
Orion really designed the wonky ruler. He's the mastermind of all of this. Okay, and I can't see. I see from the back, but I'm not sure which one this one is.
It's a log cabin, so should we do these first? Or?
Yeah, let's do that one first. Okay. Okay, so look how nice Teresa prepared everything for me. You can't wait to see it. Ta-da! Okay. We'll put it. Want to put it in the design wall?
Yeah.
We'll put it on the design wall. It's just like the shape cut. It's the same material as the shape cut. It also has a keyhole for your rotary cutter at the end and at the opposite end. And do you see right in the middle? Do you see a square? Can you see that? Okay. This is based on a 2.5-inch square, okay? 2.5-inch square. So we used it for the chimneys and cornerstones only using 2.5-inch strips for our 9-patch. And you can also use it for the log cabin, which we'll show you next. A log cabin with a 2.5-inch center square, okay? So let's just put this on here. This ruler, relax, guys. It's on back order. This might be the only ruler in the house, huh?
No.
Oh, they're not?
No.
Oh, Rick told me that you didn't have any.
No, we have plenty.
What do I know? We do have them. Okay, so 9-patch? 9-patch, all square, right? Just like we would have made it just now. So with the four darks, these are the ones that we're going to lead off of. Okay, so find the little square and line it up right in the middle. Right there, do you see that? Okay, do you see it says one? See, I can even figure this out. So you take your cutter, you put it in one. Whoops. You got to hold that down tight and cut through one. On one side, pick it up, one. On the second side, okay. Take it off. Ah, it's getting wonky, huh? Ah, wonky. Huh? Oh, yes. Snooki made it. She did it. Okay, so we did two sides. Right, we got to wonk it up a little bit more. So go back, put the center, put the little square right on top of the center. One, okay. So what do you think? Is that pretty easy? If you just do one, okay, and then you go over here, do one, and get rid of these, and that's as wonky as you'd want it. Very interesting, huh? Whoa, thank you. Okay, so then, look, Teresa prepared me such a nice little stack. Are we sewing these now, Teresa?
Sure.
Oh.
You trim it.
Okay, so we have one on this side and one on this side, right? Okay, so flip it right sides together. Oh, cool. That's good. Okay, and let's just pick up the two pieces. The next two pieces she's got already. We got so excited. She was going to be the elf, and then she backed out at the last minute. We said, oh, she was so cute as, what was the one she did?
Carmen
Miranda. Carmen Miranda. I was upstairs, and I found that little outfit. We might have to do that at Paducah 12 times, Teresa.
Good thing they Julie practiced.
You look really good in that. She made Julie do that. Okay, so does this look similar? The 9-patch, you're sewing two strips, but remember these are 2.5-inch strips, okay? 2.5. Okay, so you want to go press them quick? All right. And so to do these little sides, one, and two, what you really need to do is measure
the size of your nine patch. Okay, so let's see. The size of your nine patch is, looks like 4.5 inches. So this has to be 4.5 inches. And you add the two little pieces on the side. Okay, let's open it up again. All right, that looks good. 2.5-inch strips. Oh, you can really sew good, Teresa. I always tell everybody whenever I'm on a trip, people think I do everything.
I wish. I can't do everything.
I say, no, Teresa helps me do a lot of her sewing, my sewing. Our sewing, my sewing. All right, one more side. Put it on there. So this would be round one, don't you think? Want to wonk it up? Okay, we'll wonk it up. We'll just keep on wonkying. So we do have the rulers for sale? Oh, she brought in a stack. Okay, so press toward round one. Set the seams, open, and press. Good, good. Okay, pick up the ruler. So what do I do?
Line up the square.
Line up the square right in the middle. Line up the square in the middle. Okay, that's good. Now what do I look for?
Two.
Is that easy enough?
Yeah.
There's two. Okay. Okay, put it, cut it. One, two. Okay. Let's take it away. Wonky, wonky. Now what? Swing it around. Line up the square. Is this easy? Brenda tested this with the bucket list people, and she said, and what did you say about it, Brenda? Give the mic to Brenda. You said,
oh, it was fantastically fun, actually. Oh. We made that one up there.
Yeah.
In class.
The log cabin.
Yeah.
Well, what you said was this was really easy, and it was so easy to understand.
Yes, it was great fun.
Great
and then
fun.
We played around with it and flipped it upside down and realized you could tilt it and turn it all kinds of ways. Yeah.
Just a few hours.
Yeah, a couple hours.
Oh, yeah. Well, we're going to – this is with – the Chimneys and Cornerstones, which you can do. Right now, Merritt is working on a pattern. I'd say it's almost done, Chimneys and Cornerstones. But the one that is currently included with the ruler is the Twisted Log Cabin. And that's it. It's the twist. You go round and round and up and down, right? And it is really wonky, isn't it? Okay, so Teresa keeps on going and going, and you get the idea, right?
Yeah.
Okay, and so then you just put the pieces on the sides. Oops, that's not right.
Yes, it is.
It is? Oh, the fabric looks really weird. Okay, would you like to see the log cabins? There's more log cabins on the floor. She's going to get the block completely done. Okay, Patty, you going to help me?
Okay.
Log cabin! And this was, is that funny? This one is a 9-block log cabin that I wonked up. And this was just scraps. I wonked it up higher.
Wow.
And it was just all my scraps. It was probably like a jelly roll that I sorted out. And all of the background is the same color. And it was just really fun to do. And you can see that I did like a zigzag layout. That was fun. I did this for my log home. If it ever gets to my log home, that would be really fun. Wow. So you do the same thing with the log cabin, 2.5-inch strips. Okay, and the next one. Hello, Benjamin. We're nearly done. Okay, and this one Gail did with romantic fabrics. And she did in the layout that we refer to as all sevens. This is the third dark.
And she arranged the always the third dark in the same direction, the same order. So it actually looks like the dark colors are framing the blocks. Different?
Two jelly rolls.
And it's a beautiful border around the outside. And you can see she put a nice check, nice plaid on the back side. Oh, and the cover of the top. Yes, put the words in my mouth. Oh, that was the first time we ever had video. The boys were sitting on the couch, and they didn't know it was a video camera, and I said, talk. This is the pattern that's included with the ruler, and that is the quilt that is photographed on the front. And it's all spilled out for you. Is that fun?
Yes.
Did we have enough fun?
Yes.
Good. I'm really glad. So, do we have sharing? I have sharing. You're not going to believe this. I actually got something done. I got the top done, but no binding. Well, I thought that was pretty good. You want to see what I did? I showed you this quilt last month. Ta-da! And I went and I sewed it all together. The nouveau wedding ring. And so it has that cool quarter patch right in the middle. Good. I'm really happy with it now that it's all put together and quilted. I think it's a lot of fun. Yes, we have one coming. Come around here and share and show us. Whoa, you girls didn't disappoint me. Come around. Ah, who's coming? Come around, Marilyn. You're here. Yay, Sandy. Let's see what you... Oh, very lovely. Good job. Good job. Sandy, do you want to talk about it?
Here, I'll hold it. You talk.
I have made something every single month. Good. But as soon as the double wedding ring came up, I went, oh, no. But it really wasn't hard at all. And that's why I just made a table runner. But I really like it. I think it's very pretty.
Say
it's
that
the first
again.
Time I ever did a double wedding ring.
Yes.
I wouldn't have done it if it weren't for you.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
I'll pay
Thank
you,
you
later.
Thank you. Okay.
That was perfect. Did you hear what she said? It wasn't hard at all? Yay! Oh, we know that Lois.
I've done a lot of double wedding rings.
Oh my gosh, this is your show. Come over here, right in this spot.
This
and
one
I'm
was
gonna
done
hold them for you.
By hand.
Okay.
That one was I'll done by hand. Years ago, I decided while traveling.
Wow.
I would do a hand.
So you did this on the plane.
Yes, this was all done traveling when we were visiting our son, who unfortunately lives a long way away.
Beautiful.
But now I've discovered applique, so I've decided I like that better than hand piecing. This was a bear, and I had really had to pound it to get it to lay flat, which I did
Sit
not
on.
Have with the other one. Then
Sit
my next
the
project
plate.
With the double wedding ring.
Okay, so
I did 81 of these blocks, and I didn't bring it all in. And I thought I was going to use up all my scrap batiks.
It's a pillow sham.
Yeah, it's a pillow sham. I have two pillow shams plus.
Look. Is that cool? Pillow sham on the back. That is really nice. But so you can use them all up. This is the pieced one.
That's the pieced one.
Yes.
That took forever.
Yes. And?
Now, I did this, and I thought this was going to go faster, but then something happened. We had a problem with our house, like a leak. So anyway.
It's beautiful, Lois.
But this went together much faster. I still have to finish the quilting.
It's really nice, though.
But it's this beautiful. I will get done in less than 15 years.
Show the back because it's beautiful. Isn't that gorgeous?
That was in my stash and is probably older than my kids. But
older than dirt, huh? So actually, you could use this as a flip side. That's very lovely. Very, very nice.
But it will be
very
done by
nice.
Next fall for a table runner.
Thank you, Lois. That's gorgeous. All right, Linda. Oh, you'd probably like these back, huh? What do you think?
Forgot
There you go. All right. Are these going to be double wedding rings?
No, not all of them.
Not all of them. Come right over in this spot.
I played catch up this month. This is 3 months' worth.
Okay. Do you want me to hold one at a time, and you can share?
This was last month's Geese in the Garden.
Oh.
I was sort of inspired by Sue's miniature class that I watched on the web.
Isn't that cute? That's adorable.
And it's a little wall hanging.
That is adorable. Okay. All right, we're going to trade.
And this is this month's wedding ring. I was sitting at the
new
dinette that my son got for Thanksgiving, and I thought, oh, he needs a table runner.
Look how nice that is.
Making one. And these are his colors in his house.
Nice. Did you give it to him yet?
Not yet.
It's going to be a Christmas present?
Uh-huh.
Adorable. Did you do your own quilting?
I did do my own quilting.
I'm impressed.
Thank you.
How about you? You're saving some money. I love this fabric on the back.
This is Eliane.
I could tell. Which, by the way, is coming out in 3 new color lines.
Oh, I love this line. It's very pretty.
4? Oh, my gosh. I can't. Let's see. Oh, my goodness. This is gorgeous.
My 10-year-old granddaughter just got her own room. She was sharing with her sister, and I thought, oh, good, I'm going to make a new quilt for her bed.
That is beautiful.
And it's mostly Eliane, just a couple other little things.
That is gorgeous.
Thank you. Wow. I enjoyed it a lot.
This
fabric
is
fun. Fabric is very fun to work with if you love the color line.
Yeah, it is really, really gorgeous.
Thank you. Thank you.
I love it. It's too bad you're giving it to your granddaughter. I know somebody else that would really love it.
Oh, yeah?
A lot of work, isn't it?
It was a lot of work, and I did.
That is beautiful.
But it's beautiful.
Good. You did good. All right, Linda. All right, Marilyn. Oh, you have a miniature, too. I can't wait to see. Oh!
Wait a minute. We got two of the left there.
Oh, my gosh. Is that cute?
Not to be outdone.
Yeah. Geese in the Garden, and like Linda said, I was inspired by Sue's webcast.
That's adorable.
Civil War reproduction.
That is adorable. Sue is in Australia now. Don't you feel bad for her? And she's going to New Zealand as well. So she's even watching us. Hi, Sue. She could. She could. This is adorable.
And this is my wedding ring. It's another Project Linus, so it's made out of novelty fabric.
Oh. It's really cute out of just the two fabrics and then the little cornerstones. That's adorable.
Thank you.
You know that she gives these to Linus. They are all given away. Isn't that special?
Yes, it is.
Very, very nice.
Thank you.
Very, very nice. Good job, Marilyn. There you go. Okay, Rose. Oh, you did a Christmas one. Did you do Christmas? Oh, look at this.
Wow.
Look at that, Benjamin. Isn't that good?
Yes.
Wow, that is gorgeous. Gold fabrics.
And
really sparkly.
I quilted it with gold thread, and I quilted it on my home Baby Lock Quilters Tours Professional.
On your Baby Lock?
Yes.
For the love.
Yes.
That is gorgeous.
Very nice.
I really, really like that. Really like that. Do you have a time estimate? No?
No.
I got it done in a month.
That's good. Quilt in a day in a month. That's really cool. That is really cool. I love it. I love it. All right. Anybody else? Anybody else? No? Okay. Okay, Santa, would you help me say thank you for coming? Would that be you, Carmen? Oh, I thought you were going to come up in front and say, oh, no, she can't. Oh, we have Santa in the back, all of you. I'm so excited that you came for the whole year. And be kind to each other. Have a wonderful Merry Christmas. Thank you.
Yay! Here comes
come Santa Claus, here come Santa Claus, right down Santa Claus Lane. Blixin' and blixin' and all his reindeers pulling on the reins. Bells are ringing, children singing, all is merry and bright. So hang your stockings and say your prayers, cause Santa Claus comes tonight. Here comes Santa Claus, here comes Santa Claus, right down Santa Claus Lane. He's got a bag that's filled with toys for boys and girls again. Hear those sleigh bells jingle, jangle, oh, what a beautiful sight. So jump in bed and cover your head, cause Santa Claus comes tonight.